I finally lose my temper and go on to write about the oppression to feel good about myself. As if to say I did my part, right? Or what more could I have done? Or we can't really change the world, can we? We have all learned to do good things and document them just in case we are asked about the proof of being the protagonist. Like that one time, you fed the birds and wrote a poem about the cage they were in and how inhuman it was and tagged PETA. Or like that one time, you clicked pictures of the protest and the people suffering, uploaded them with captions like wreckage and sacrifice. You create tears out of air and bring bodies to the scene. You make everything look alive enough to allow them to breathe their last breaths, maybe just poetic enough. For everything to become a metaphor, implying that all of this is something bigger than what it actually is, but is this a caged bird poem? Tell me, how do you fit in the whole landscape view of a city full of structured oppression into a red Instagram display without understanding what a systematic death is, what a premeditated murder was, what a poem about the dead caged birds will feel like? Tell me, how will you lay down a map to a city in words that will never belong to you, into stories that will turn into statistics of more dead caged birds, into war heroes who questioned if what they did was right or wrong, into us questioning if we should support the right, into patriotism that we won't be able to justify without calling it a brainwash, brainwash verb, pressurize someone into adopting radically different beliefs by using systematic enforceable means, example. I did my part, right? What more could I have done? We can't really change the world, can we? The man on the roof, as some say, is a crazy man, but not crazy enough to be called crazy, crazy enough to start a cult and bring in followers and give those followers a name, crazy enough to do the rituals and call them rituals instead of calling it a murder. They call him Kabootarbaaz, which translates into bird whisperer. He's the kind that can legitimize the crazy, the kind who skips to page 5 because he doesn't really care about the dead bodies, only the match against Pakistan. The type who offers the sky to the flock of birds. He calls the birds back to the cages and says, look, it's safer this way. Which always had a connotation of, don't make me kill you for a god that we won't even remember because there are so many of them. He owns more cages than birds now. The funny part is he never named the birds, always segregated them. The ones that would come back and the ones that wouldn't. He named the cages though. Call the cages Jamhuriyat, which is Urdu for democracy. So tell me, who are we to blame the bird for not being able to differentiate between a glass window or a clear sky? Kabootarbaaz calls the birds that never came back traitors, and the ones that did could become whatever they wanted to be. I call myself privileged. Instead of calling myself a murderer, I call myself woke because that's all I have left as an excuse. We call this a bad day, a dark one. A day that consists of the taste of the next 5 years of bad days. Now the Kabootarbaaz offers the sky to the flock of birds, knowing they'll always turn around. I imagine how much time did it take for him to strip each bird of its right and then turn their wings into a privilege. BJP has been in power for 6 years now, which is to say we have learned to fly through glass windows by not trying to fly at all. I come from a country of revolutionaries, the ones whose blood spilled only to be used as a fertilizer for growing out a motherland that we'll never be able to garden. So don't give me a lecture on the collateral of a war that shouldn't have been fought to begin with. I imagine what he did to the birds that never turned around. Some say they have evidence of the hidden skeletons but are not allowed to show them because they might end up calling a panel discussion on it and ending it as propaganda. Some say if you look hard enough at the lake in Kashmir, it'll reflect all the red that filled all of our Instagrams. But 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months is not a long enough time for anyone to be declared missing or dead or carcass. We can only declare them as traitors. The ones that never came back to the cages, remember? The Kabootarbaaz declared them as anti-national. Anti-national, adjective, opposed to national interest or nationalism. Example, terrorists, Kashmir, Muslims, JNU, Jamia. Maybe we have learned to breathe in atrocities and call the consequences post-Diwali odd-even rule. Maybe I'm performing this poem out of survivor's guilt, or maybe I'm choosing not to turn around and follow the Kabootarbaaz. Maybe some of us are dying faster than we are evolving. So when a 7-year-old girl at Shaheen Bagh screams, "Hum kya chahte," only for an azadi to be followed, I imagine how much time does she have left before she realizes it's not a game anymore. Kabootarbaazi is an ancient game started in the Mughal period where birds raced each other only to entertain the king. I hope she knows how oppression can turn into a pleasure. So when the last Mughal, Bahadur Shah Zafar, was stripped from his powers by the British, he was locked at the Red Fort to be put on display. I wonder if he also saw the irony in that. I wonder if he also wrote a poem about the dead caged birds. I wonder if we have anything in common. But this time, when the protest ended, the protagonist in me went back home. All of us called the privileges back to our spines. We walk straighter now. Like the people who will be alive to have an opinion tomorrow would walk like. Like the people who will sing national anthems in movie theaters again. Like the people who believe the Kabootarbaaz when he said, Sab Sangasi. Like the obedient flock of birds who will always turn around. Now, when the kids at Shaheen Bagh play Chidiya Ud, a game to kill time because the electricity is out, I try not to call it a handcrafted metaphor that can put a landscape view of a city full of structured oppression into a poem that we'll never do justice to. I hope they know the consequences of not flying away when they had the chance to. Thank you.